Welcome dear students in the 8th standard maths class. In the previous video we have completed practice set 7.1. Now in this video we'll start the next topic. Here the one table is given. This table shows the number of rows and number of students in each row when they are made to stand for drill. So number of students in a row are 40, then the number of rows are formed 6. When the number of students in a row are 10, then how many rows are formed? 24. Because we know the total number of students are 240. So when the number of students in a row are 24, then total number of rows are 10. So see, if we take the product of both the quantities here, here two quantities are given, number of students in a row and number of rows. So if we take the product at each instant, see it is 240. Means here 240 is a same means it is a constant. So here see, if we compare both the instants here, if the first quantity is decreases, then second quantity is increases. And when the first quantity is increases, then second quantity is decreases, correct? So here exactly opposite is formed. So therefore it is called as a inverse proportion. And here the product of both quantity is constant. Constant means same. Understood? So how to read the inverse variation? The statement x, here two quantities are given, x and y. So x is inversely proportional to y. Or there is inverse variation in x and y. So if x and y are inverse proportion, then x into y is constant. So assuming constant is k, to solve the problems. So if the x inversely varies as y, is written as in the mathematics x alpha 1 upon y. Okay, take the reciprocal of second quantity. So if x is inversely varies as y, then x is equal to k upon y, or x into y is equal to k, because their product is constant. So this is the equation of variation, where k is the constant of variation. Very simple. So see the solve questions in your textbook. F is inversely proportional to d square. So when d is equal to 5 and f is equal to 18, hence if the d is equal to 10, then find the f. So firstly we have to find the k by using these both values. So f is inversely varies as d square, therefore f into d square is equal to k. Therefore 18 multiplied by 5 equal to k. Therefore k is equal to 5 square. Therefore k is equal to 18 multiplied by 25. Is equal to 450. This is the constant of variation. And put it into the equation. So f into d square is equal to 450. So if d is equal to 10, then f is equal to question mark. So write down the equation of variation. F into d square is equal to 450. So therefore f into d is given, so 10 square is equal to 450. So therefore f into 10 square is 100 equal to 450. Therefore, f is equal to 4.5. Let us move to the practice set 7.2. First question, the information about number of workers and number of days to complete a work is given in the following table. Complete the table. So here number of workers and days are given. So when the days are given, then we have to find out the number of workers. And when the number of workers are given, we have to find out the days by using the equation of variation. So but here the variation type of variation is not mentioned. So firstly, we have to find out the type of variation. See here, to do the any work, if the more workers are complete that task, then less number of days are required to complete the same task, correct? So when the number of workers are increases, then number of days are decrease. So this question is based on the inverse variation. And here no labels are mentioned for both quantities. So firstly, we assume the n for the number of workers and d for the days. See the solution. Let number of workers be n and days be d. So therefore, if number of workers are more, then less number of days are required to do the same task. Therefore, this is the example. This example is based on inverse variation. Therefore, number of workers be n is inversely varies as days. 1 upon d. Therefore, n is equal to k upon d, where k is a constant. Therefore, n into d is equal to k. This is the equation of variation. Now the first, n is equal to 30, then d is equal to 6. Put these values into the equation to find out the value of k. Therefore, 30 into 6 is equal to k. Therefore, k is equal to 180. Therefore, n into d is equal to 180. This is the equation of variation. Now see the second. D is equal to 12. N is equal to question mark. Correct? So put it into the equation. N into 12 is equal to 180. Therefore, n is equal to 180 divided by 12. Therefore, n is equal to 50. See the second. Not second, third. When n is equal to 10, then find out the d. Put it into the equation. 10 into d is equal to 180. therefore d is equal to 180 divided by 10, therefore n, sorry, d is equal to 18. Now see the fourth. When d is equal to 36, n is equal to question mark. So put it into equation. Therefore, into n is equal to 180. Therefore, n is equal to 180 divided by 36. So therefore, n is equal to 5. Now put all these values in the table. So when the days are 12, then number of workers are 15. When the number of workers are 10, then 18 days are required. And when the number of days are 36, then how many workers are required? 5. So in this way, the table is completed. Now second, find the constant of variation and write the equation of variation for every example given below. So we will find it one by one. See the solution. P is inversely varies as Q. Therefore, P is equal to K upon Q. Therefore, P into Q is equal to K. Where K is constant and PQ is equal to K is the equation of variation. Now substituting the values of P and Q. P equal to 15 and Q equal to 4. Therefore equation becomes 15 multiplied by 4 is equal to K. Therefore K is equal to 60. This is the constant of variation. And put it into the equation. Therefore P into Q is equal to 60 is the equation of variation. Now see the next. Z is inversely varies as Y. When the Z is equal to 2.5, then W is equal to 24. Then find the constant of variation and equation of variation. So solution, we know that Z is inversely varies as W. Therefore Z is equal to K upon W. Therefore Z into W is equal to K, where K is constant. Now substituting the values of Z and W, we get, therefore equation becomes 2.5 multiplied by 24 is equal to K. Therefore K is equal to 60. This is the constant of variation. Now put it into the equation. Z into W is equal to 60 is the equation of variation. Very simple. Now see the third. S is inversely varies as T square. So when the S is 4 and the T is 5, then find the equation of variation and constant of variation. So solution, We know that s is inversely varies as t square. Therefore, s is equal to k upon t square. Therefore, s into t square is equal to k, where k is a constant. Constant. Now substituting, s equal to 4 and t equal to 5. We get, therefore equation becomes 4 into pi square is equal to k. Therefore 4 into 25 is equal to k. Therefore k equal to 100. This is the constant of variation. Now put it into equation. So what is our equation? S into t square is equal to value of k is 100. This is the equation of variation. Very simple. See the next. X is inversely varies as root y. If the x is 15 and y is 9, then find the constant of variation and equation of variation. So solution, x is inversely varies as root y. Therefore x is equal to k upon root y. Therefore x into root y is equal to k, where k is constant. So now substituting, x is equal to 15 and y is equal to 9 in the equation. Therefore equation becomes 15 multiplied by root 9 equal to k. Therefore 15 multiplied by root 9, 9 is a perfect square, so root 9 is 3 equal to k. Therefore k is equal to 15 threes are 45. This is the constant of variation. Put it into the equation. So therefore x into root y is equal to 45 is the equation of variation. Very simple. See the next question. The boxes are to be filled with apples in a heap. If 24 apples are put in a box, then 27 boxes are needed. If 36 apples are filled in a box, how many boxes will be needed? See, the size of box is same. So when the number of apples are more, then less number of boxes are needed. Correct? Therefore, this is the example of inverse variation. So firstly, we assume the variables here for both the quantities, number of apples and number of boxes are given here. See the solution. Let number of apples be x and the boxes needed to fill them be y. So we know that more the number of apples in a box, then less is the number of boxes required to fill them. Therefore, this is the example of inverse variation. Correct? So write it into the equation form. Therefore, x is inversely varies as y. Therefore, x is equal to k upon y. Therefore, x into y is equal to k, where k is a constant. So, when x is equal to 24, y is equal to 27. So, put it into equation. So, 24 into 27 is equal to k. Therefore, k equal to 648 is the constant of variation. So, put it into equation. X into y is equal to 648. The value of k is the equation of variation. Now, substituting, x is equal to 36. So, equation becomes 36 into y is equal to 648. Therefore, y is equal to 648 divided by 36. So, therefore, y is equal to 18. So, write down the answer line. 18 boxes will be required. Very simple. See the fourth question. Write the following statement using the symbol of variation. So first is the wavelength of sound L and its frequency F are in inverse variation. So it is very easy. L inversely varies as f means it is 1 upon f. See the second, the intensity I of light varies inversely with the square of distance d of a screen from the lamp. So here first quantity is denoted by I. Inversely varies the square of distance, so 1 upon d square, correct? Now see the next question, fifth question. X is inversely varies root y, and when x is equal to 40, then y is equal to 16. If x is equal to 10, then find the value of y. Very simple question. See the solution, what is given? X is inversely varies as root of y. So, therefore, x is equal to k upon root y. Therefore, x into root y is equal to k, where k is a constant. Now, substituting, x equal to 40 and y equal to 16. So, equation becomes 40 into root 16 is equal to k. So, therefore, 40 multiplied by 16 is a perfect square. So, square root of 16 is 4 equal to k. Therefore, k is equal to 4 4 is 16, 160. This is the constant of variation. Now put this value into equation. Therefore, x into root y is equal to 160 is the equation of variation. Now calculate the value of y when the x is 10. So substituting x is equal to 10. So put this value into equation. So therefore equation becomes 10 into root y is equal to 160. Therefore root y is equal to 160 divided by 10. 0, 0 cancel. Therefore root y equal to 16. So now we want the value of y. So therefore y is equal to 16 square. Squaring to both sides. Therefore y is equal to 256. Very simple. See the next question. X varies inversely as y. When x is equal to 15, then y is equal to 10. If x is equal to 20, then y is equal to ? See the solution. X is inversely varies as y. Therefore, x is equal to k upon y. Therefore, x into y is equal to k, where k is a constant. Now find the equation of variation. So substituting x equal to 15 and y equal to 10. So equation becomes, therefore 15 multiplied by 10 is equal to k. Therefore k is equal to 150. This is the constant of variation. Now put this value of k into the equation. Therefore x into y is equal to 150. This is the equation of variation. Now by using this equation, find the value of y. By substituting the value of x is equal to 20. So put it into the above equation. Therefore equation becomes 20 into y is equal to 150. So therefore y is equal to 150 divided by 20. So 2 7s are 14. Therefore y is equal to 7.5. And this is the answer. So here practice set 7.2 is over. Thank you.